Hey everyone, welcome to Study Time. I pray that you're having a great morning so far, and if not, I pray that it gets better, and I pray that you have a blessed day. Man, look, so much is going on, as we can tell, in the world today, and I just pray that whoever looks at this video, I pray that you have Jesus in your heart, because we never know when that day is, and we never know when that time may be where the Lord will call us home. And I just want to encourage you today to just continue to hold on and be strong, because Jesus is coming very, very, very soon. So today we're going to jump into a scripture, and I just want to encourage you with this scripture today. And it comes from Romans 12 verses 1 through 2. Again, that's Romans 12 verse 1 through 2. And we're going to, like I said, go ahead and read right now, and it'll be on the screen just in case you may not have it in front of you. Let's go. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, His good, pleasing, and perfect will. Again, that's Romans 12 verses 1 through 2. Right now, we're going to go ahead and step into a time of, if you want to become a Christian and a believer in Jesus Christ, you have the opportunity right now. If you feel like there's something missing in your life, that's because it is missing, and that's a relationship with Jesus Christ. Doesn't matter if you're a good person, doesn't matter if you go to church every Sunday, it doesn't matter that you do good to others, you give to the church. What matters is that you have a relationship with Jesus Christ and you believe in Him. So after this break, we'll come back and do some commentary, and I hope that if you need Jesus in your life, you'll accept Him today. And you'll see me when we get back. Bye.
Welcome to the Prayer for Salvation. This is simply a video I've put together where I'd like to pray for anyone within the sound of my voice. All I ask you to do is to agree with me as we seek our Father God. Choosing to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior is the most important decision you will ever make. Remember, it's not about how you feel after you pray. When the Bible says it, that settles it, and God promises to save you when you ask. God's word promises, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. By his grace, God has already done everything to provide salvation for you, regardless of your past. Your part is to simply believe and receive. So the very moment you commit your life to Jesus Christ, the truth of his word instantly comes to pass in your spirit, and when you're born again, there's a brand new you. Pray out loud after me. Jesus, I confess that you are my Lord and Savior. I believe in my heart that God raised him from the dead. By faith in your word, I receive salvation now. Thank you for saving me. I am now reborn. I am a Christian, a child of Almighty God. I am saved. Thank you, Jesus.
All right, so to those of you who said that salvation prayer and meant it from your heart and accepted Jesus Christ, congratulations. You just made the best decision of your life, and I promise you won't regret it. Not just because you have an eternal set place to go, which is heaven, but you can experience benefits now here as well. So let's go ahead and jump into the commentary. I'm going to be in the footnotes now, reading from Romans 12 verses 1 and 2, and I hope that this helps you understand the scripture just a little bit better. All right, let's go. When sacrificing an animal according to God's law, a priest would kill the animal, cut it in pieces, and place it on the altar. Sacrifice was important, but even in the Old Testament, God made it clear that obedience from the heart was much more important. God wants us to offer ourselves not animals, as living sacrifices. Daily laying aside our own desires to follow Him, putting all of our energy and resources at His disposal, and trusting Him to guide us. We do this out of gratitude that our sins have been forgiven. God has good, pleasing, and perfect plans for His children. He wants us to be transformed people with renewed minds, living to honor and obey Him, because He wants only what is best for us, and because He gave His Son to make our new life possible, we should joyfully give ourselves as living sacrifices for His service. Paul warned Christians, do not be conformed to this age, which is selfish and corrupting. Many Christians wisely decide that a large portion of the world's behavior is off limits for them. Our refusal to conform to this world, however, must go even deeper than just behavior and customs. It must be firmly planted in the values rooted in our mind. Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. It is possible to avoid most worldly customs and still be proud, covetous, selfish, stubborn, and arrogant. Only when the Holy Spirit renews, re-educates, and redirects our mind are we truly transformed. So I pray that you got that, and you may have to go back and kind of rewind this video to get those footnotes again. But as you can see in the world that we live in today, so much is going on, and it's just so much going on that's against the Word of God. So that's why I wanted to share the scripture with you today, to encourage you to renew your mind. Let the Word of God renew your mind, so that you may not be a smoker. But why are you not a smoker? Are you not a smoker just because we shouldn't do that? Or in your mind is renewed to say that our body is the temple, and the temple of the Holy Ghost, and for God. We use our body for God, so we don't want to harm our body. So it's those kind of things where your mind is renewed through scripture that you don't do certain things, or you do certain things. So I want to encourage you today to continue. If you want to continue to read Romans 12, go for it, because it's a great scripture. I just got out of the book of Romans myself. But again, I wanted to encourage you with that scripture today, and stay focused on what God is saying and what God is doing, because so much is before us as we see today, and there's so much foolishness and demonic activity going on from what you see on TV, what you hear on the radio, and if not careful, you'll be fooled by what you see. So keep a close relationship with God, because a lot of people that may even talk for God today, you can't even trust them, because they're not in their word and they're not before God as well. So stay and keep a close relationship with God and the Holy Spirit, and ask Him for direction. Ask Him to lead you and guide you, and He most certainly will. And before we go today, I want to encourage you with this song called I Surrender All. So this song is basically, it's a hymn, but many people have sung it, and I'm going to just play it today. So I pray that it encourages you, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Yeah.